on these benefits. Who forgiveth? And most Bible teachers I've been around, they said when you see a word with an E-T-H ending, that means continuation. Not just did it once and it's over, but does it repeatedly. And might I say, the average churchgoer today seemed to be a little cloudy in mind when it comes to the subject of forgiveness. They seemed to overlook how much it cost God to produce such a plan. It cost him something. He didn't get this at Walmart, Dollar General, Dollar Tree. It cost him something. He died to bring the captain out of the clutches of the devil. The devil wanted him to go to hell with him, but Jesus rescued him. Let me go and wrap this up. I don't need to take all night. When I looked at the word benefit and the word forgive me, then I reached the conclusion that the subject tonight is forgiveness, a life-changing benefit. I don't know anything that changed your life like being forgiven. You see, say it slow, John. Don't say this too fast. As much as you would like to go to heaven, you cannot go without being forgiven. As bad as you say, you hate the devil. He will not let you go unless your sins have been forgiven and you appreciate being forgiven enough to tell the devil, I ain't following you. Something down inside of me saying you come this far and you find no fault, you ought to go on with him. He is the best thing ever happened to you. And then when you don't feel good, why don't you let pop for a minute and have a Thanksgiving service? Thank you, Lord. Thank you for not cutting me off. Thank you for not turning your back on me. Thank you for not walking away. Thank you for giving me hope. Thank you for giving me life. Thank you for dying on my behalf. Thank you for the blood. Thank you for the spirit. Thank you for the life. Thank you. You know, we have a traditional thing called Thanksgiving. But I dare you to read Psalm 136. Because just about every verse, thanks, oh, give thanks unto the Lord, for he is good, his mercy endureth forever. Oh, give thanks unto the Lord, and on and on and on. His mercy endureth forever. What is mercy? Mercy is God's ability to have compassion upon the pitiful. And if anybody was pitiful, it was you and I. Born in trespass and sin, born blind, busted, disgusted, downcast, bewildered, bound, imprisoned, lost, and hopeless. And anybody who messed with us had to have mercy upon us. Because the shape we were in, nothing we could do. We needed a savior. We needed a rescuer. We needed a deliverer. We needed hope. We needed somebody who had mercy upon us. I want to thank you for the time I was too weak to thank you. I want to thank you for the time I was too cold to thank you. Thank you, thank you, thank you, thank you, thank you. selfish to thank you, too occupied to thank you. And sometimes too proud, because I was surrounded by people that I thought was more dignified, and I didn't want to get lose my composure. Feel faint. I feel like I can run through troops.